The love of football starts at a young age.
I grew up a huge Cowboys fan.
For Carl, school pictures prove it, and he says this team is the foundation of a lifelong friendship.
We've been best friends since we were, 10 years old, met in fourth grade.
Carl and Josh have the Cowboys imprinted in their hearts and on their arms. So when they found out the NFL draft would be in Arlington.
Oh, I wouldn't miss it.
All the way from Florida and Arkansas, they booked their flights and hotel and started looking for tickets.
I decided instead of just searching for tickets for sale, I would just post a wanted ad and see if any sellers would call me.
Someone made an offer, two VIP passes for $300. The seller claimed to be a season ticket holder.
Every question that I seemed to ask him, he seemed to have an answer for right away, basically without thinking.
After back and forth text messages, the payment was made, and it still seemed legitimate for a while.
I'll send you your tickets and we'll be on our way. And then I never heard from him again. His phone goes straight to voicemail. His mailbox is full.
Now it's day one of the draft, and Carl is out $300 with no access to AT&T Stadium.
So it's enter at your own risk.
Felicia Clark with the Better Business Bureau says he is one of many victims.
Scammers are becoming more and more sophisticated.
And more, the internet savvy generation is being scammed.
Don't think that they're not going to target you as well.
With tickets sold out by the vendor, Clark knows it's risky to buy them any other way, so it's important to protect yourself.
Whatever way they ask you to pay, check to see if there is fraud protection before you use it.
As for Carl and Josh, they made it to Texas this afternoon and are still hoping for some way, somehow, to attend the NFL draft.
We're definitely going to try and make the most of it.
Tiffany Liu, Channel 8 News.